completed in the statistics, in the textbook statistics. All right, complete or not? Statistics textbook, three chapters complete or not? Okay, affirmative. Okay, that's fine. Okay, so three chapters that will include in the examination. Okay, and from our book microeconomics, we completed one chapter, right? So far we completed one chapter. That chapter also will include. So all together, four chapters are there for your examination. Clear? Four chapters are there for your examination. Constitute of 30 marks. 30 marks. Note down 30 marks. 30 marks. So just note down the question paper pattern. Question paper pattern. 1 mark. 1 mark questions all together for 17 marks. 17 marks. We can divide like this. I mean MCQs. Oh, 7 marks. MCQ, sir. 7 marks. Fill in the blanks. Hanna Salim, are you noting down that? Hanna?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, fine. So MCQs for 7 marks. Next one, 5 mark. Fill in the blanks. Next, VVS. Very, very short answer questions. That's for 5 marks. That's for 5 marks. Okay. So all together, 1 mark for 17. 17 marks. That is the distribution mark, distribution for 1 mark. This is the division. MCQ, fill in the blanks, and VVS. Very, very short answers. Next one, 3 mark one. 3 mark one. So 17 plus 3, 20. 4 mark one. One question for 4 mark. Next one, 6 mark one question. Okay, this is the division. So out of 14 students, so far only 7 participants are there. What happened to the other students? Any idea? All are tensed and sitting in home, waiting for the result. I'm thinking so, right? Whatever it is, we will continue with our top topic there. Okay, only 7 are there. Only 50% is the presence here. Okay, let it. So in the contest with the examination, I want to ask you something. So this class I'm using for interaction. All right, basically, we completed one chapter. If you have any doubt regarding that, you want any more explanation regarding that, or you want explanation for these textual questions, any doubt regarding the NCERT solutions, you can ask me. I'll explain that. Okay, can we start that? Shall I ask some questions for you? Are you able to answer? So nearly I conducted nearly 8 to 9 classes to complete that one chapter. Okay. So I'm thinking that you people are able to answer me, able to give the answers. Are you? Aishwarya, are you? Able, no problem. So notes are there with you. You wrote your notes. You checked the notes, what I uploaded, and everything is fine. I'm thinking with you, right? Okay, then Amal Raj. Okay, we are asking some simple things, some basic things in the chapter there. What are the factors of production, man? Tell me, Amal Raj.
Land. Capital.
Land, capital.
Organizer.
Correct. One more.
The labor.
Labor, fine. Land, labor, capital, and organizer. Land, labor, capital, and organizer. So, what is the name of this chapter? Introduction. Introduction to what? Microeconomics. So in this introduction chapter, you want to learn almost all the terms what we are going to use in the coming chapters. That's what I repeatedly explain each and every concept for many times. I think so many times, 3, 4, 5. I don't know how many times I explained all these things there. So land, labor, capital, and organizer. We want all these terms and all meaning of all these things for the future classes. So tell me, Abarna, what are the remuneration for all these factors of production? Example, for land, what is that? Labor, what is that? For organizer, what is that? And for the capital, what is that? Tell me.
Sir, land, it is rent.
Rent.
Then labor wages.
Labor wages.
Then capital.
Capital.
Interest.
Interest, very good. And with the
organizer, profit or sometimes loss.
Profit or loss. Yeah, sometimes loss. Correct. So whatever not all, that is all correct. All those things are correct there. Remuneration for land is rent. And the remuneration for labor is wages or salary. You know that. Next one is a capital. That is a interest, right? Next one is organizer. It's profit or loss. Risk is there. Risk is there with the organizer. Every time the organizer want to face the risk. So risk bearing capacity, that give him profit. Sometimes loss also. Clear? So we know that. Next question to Abarna. What are the difference between, or tell me what do you mean by microeconomics, Abarna? What we are going to learn or what we are learning in microeconomics and what is the scope of microeconomics? Microeconomics. Tell me, Abarna. Sorry, Aishwarya, not Abarna, Aishwarya.
Question and see.
What do you mean by microeconomics? Microeconomics.
In microeconomics, we learn about the problems individuals face and in a all problems in a smaller quantity.
Okay, a small portion. Basically, a small unit, a micro unit, maybe an individual or a firm or a firm. Micro units, we are discussing the problems of a micro unit that we are discussing in microeconomics. Otherwise, microeconomics otherwise called as what theory?
Price theory.
Price theory. Okay, fine. So that's called microeconomics. So in this chapter, basically, we are discussing microeconomics. Then tell me, Sharath, what do you mean macroeconomics? Macroeconomics.
In macroeconomics, we study about the problems of a whole country.
Country as a whole, correct. So okay, economy as a whole. Okay, fine. That what we discussed or what you told is correct. Okay. So a broad category, thinking it is what macroeconomics. Okay. Hanna Salim.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Tell me, Hanna Salim, what do you mean GDP?
Gross domestic product.
That is the full form of GDP, right? Gross domestic product. My question, Hanna Salim, what is that? What do you mean by gross domestic product? Can I pass the question to Grishma? Hanna, want some more time to think?
Yes, sir.
Tell me then. I'm waiting. Okay, passing to Grishma. Grishma, tell me, Grishma. Hanna, remember. Okay, now Grishma is going to tell the answer. Grishma.
The wages.
So, listen carefully. What are the things we discussed is very much important.
Fixed for the products.
Pardon?
The wages fixed for products.
So, I'm asking about what is GDP? Atul, any idea?
Sir, is it the fixed value of the finished products?
Of course, coming to that.
Total value of the finished products.
Of course, that's it. That's the term. The total value. The total value of all goods and services. Take it from me, note down that. Okay. What do you mean by the term GDP? Write down somewhere. Keep it with you. You want to know that. If you don't know what is GDP, how can we study all other activities related with an economy there? Impossible, right? You want to know what is GDP. That is compulsory. Without that, we are unable to move forward. So learn that, not on that. GDP means it is the total value of GDP means it is the total value of all the goods and services, all the goods and services that produced in a country or within a country in a particular period of time. In a bracket, you want to write financial year. Now, I already told you that when a financial year will start in India. Any idea?
April 1st
of a calendar year to March 31st of the next calendar year. That's what. So take it from me. What Hanna Salim, take it from me. What is GDP? The total value of all the goods and services that are produced within a country in a particular period of time. Bracket what I told? A financial year. Financial year. Okay. So is that much clear for you? So we discussed. So far we discussed about what are the factors of production. What are the factors of production? Right. That's clear for you. What are the remuneration for each factor of the production that we discussed? Next, we discussed about what do you mean by GDP? What is a GDP? Gross domestic product. Next, we are discussing about what do you mean by per capita income? Per capita income. Per capita income. Microeconomics, that is very much important. Per capita income. Income. Per capita income. What is that? Subham Pal, just turn on your camera. Sorry, guys. Subham Pal, turn on your camera. Can anyone say that? What do you mean by per capita income?
The total income produced in a country divided by the total population of a country.
Divided by total or divided by the population. That's right, not pollution, population. Correct. Okay. So, the total income divided by the population. That is per capita income. Per head income. Capita head. Per head income. Total income divided by the population. Okay, take it from me. Shubham Pal. Shubham Pal.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Waiting for the result. Are you searching for the result? You got that?
No, sir.
Is it published?
Yes, sir.
Published?
Yes.
Result published already. Okay. Don't worry. We'll check that. Okay. So I don't know whether it published or not. So just ask Shubham Pal for a clarification. So Shubham Pal just to join now. That's what I asked him. Okay. Let it. Fine. So that's what GDP. That's what GDP. Now, in economics, basically, we are studying about one particular problem. Okay. The problem of? What is that, Amal Raj? The problem of? Basically, the economics is study of? What? What is that? Amal Raj.
Income.
Not income. Basically, we studied one particular term here. What is that? Listening? Are you listening? Amal Raj?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Aparna, what is that? Something starting with a S.
Scarcity.
Of course, scarcity. Scarcity. So we know that economics is basically study related with scarcity. So there are a number of problems we can find in each and every economy, right? Number of problems are there. So basically those problems are called, what are those problems, Hanna Salim? What are the problems?
Central problems.
Yeah, central problems of an economy. Central problems of an economy. How many are there, Sharath? How many problems are there, basically? Well, we can decide as or discussing as central problems.
Three.
How many are there?
Three.
Sorry, Sharath? Three are there, right? Yeah, I heard that. Three. What are they?
For whom to produce.
Produce. Good. Okay. Grishma. What are the causes for these problems? Sorry, everyone. What are the problems for? Or what are the causes for these problems?
Limited resources. Unlimited ones.
Unlimited ones, correct?
Resources have alternative uses.
Resources have alternative uses. Very good. What Grishma told is accurate. Correct it is. Three things are there basically that leading to the central problems in an economy. What are they? Limited resources. Shubham Pal.
Yes,
limited
sir.
Resources. Unlimited wants. Next it is alternative use of resources. Alternative use of resources. That are the things that basically leading to the central problems in an economy. Okay. So we know that. What do you mean by it? Wants? What is wants? How can we classify wants? Sarath, any idea? Or Adul, tell me. Adul, how can we classify our needs or our wants?
The demand of the people for the necessary commodities, which is required for the daily life.
Of course. Then, what is necessary?
Yes.
Accepted that. Next one. So always the demand for the people or needs for the people will fluctuate. Okay. How it will fluctuate? Necessaries to comforts, comfort to luxuries. That's it. That the divisions there basically. Necessaries, comforts, and luxuries. Okay. Clear or not? These are some basic ideas in economics. If you know all these things, it is easy to understand the coming chapters. Very easy to understand. So, like mathematics, we will study multiplication table, right? We'll study or not? Tables. Okay. Like in economics, these terms are very important. The idea of these terms are also very much important. Then only we are able to move forward. That will simplify our journey to learn economics, right? So that's what I'm repeatedly telling all these things, sir. If you're unable to understand, you ask me. I will explain that. No problem. I am assigned for that. I'm deployed for that. You can ask me. No problem for that. Okay. So you want to open your mouth, you have to ask. Then only we are able to communicate each other. So I am telling something. It's like a radio, right? You are listening. You are just the listeners. Yeah, like a radio. But what we want here? We want to complete the function of a mobile phone. Okay. You have to speak. You have to listen. The same way you have to speak too. Clear? Aparna? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Are you agreeing with me or not?
Yes, sir.
Adul? Amal Raj is too tense. I'm thinking that what happened, Amal Raj? Wait, let the result come. No problem. Okay, wait for that. No need of tension or something, right? Are you tensed, Amal Raj?
No, sir.
No. What about Grishma? Are you tense, Grishma? Grishma?
Yes, sir.
Yes, tension. No tension, you're just. Okay, whatever it is. I can hear Grishma. Okay, connection trouble is there. Shubhambal is laughing like anything. I don't know why he's that much happy. Okay, Shubhambal. Okay, Shubhambal is ready, yes, to sir. Face any consequences, right? Whatever it is, I will face. That only know. That's what the mindset.
Yes, sir.
That's what we want, right? Okay, let it. Okay, so guys, I'm going for the screen sharing. You just observe that. Just hold on for a moment. How many sectors are there in economy? Tell me. Three are there, right? Fine, correct. So Shubhambal, tell me. Shubhambal, are you interacting with someone else there? Tell me, Shubhambal, how many sectors are there in an economy?
Three sectors.
What are they?
Primary, secondary, and tertiary sector.
Primary, secondary, and tertiary sectors. Fine, correct. Okay. So we know that what are the production or what are the things that producing in all these three sectors, right? Primary sector is otherwise known as the agriculture sector. Mining is an activity there. Agriculture production, fishing, quarrying. Okay, all is connected with the primary sector. Basically, we are getting or using great help from the nature to produce the product in the primary sector. Okay, so there are a number of free gifts we are using in the primary sector. What are the free gifts we are using in the primary sector, Mr. Sharath? What are the free gifts we are using in the primary sector? Sharath? Okay, I can't connect with Sharath. Tell me, Aishwarya, what are the things? What are the free gifts we are using to produce the products in the primary sector? Tell me.
Water. Seeds and all those.
So nowadays seeds are not free, right? We want to purchase that. High yielding variety seeds, right? So what she told is correct is water, sunlight, air, okay, soil, all are considering as a free gift of the nature. So want to understand that, want to take it from me? Okay. So in the primary sector to produce the products, we required the help from the nature. Next one, secondary sector. So secondary sector. So otherwise called as industrial sector. Is that correct, Hanna Salim? The secondary sector is called industrial sector. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, basically what are the products in secondary sector? Industrial products, consumer goods. They are using the products from the, or primary products from the primary sector to produce something new in the secondary sector. Basically, agro-based industries and mineral-based industries. Agro-based and mineral-based industries. Okay, fine. That we discussed. We know the central problems of an economy. Next one, the difference between a market economy or a centrally planned economy. Market economy and a economy and a centrally planned economy. What are the differences between these things? What do you mean market economy? What is a market economy? Any idea? Anybody? Who will fix the prices in a market economy?
The government.
Market economy, who will fix the price?
Private individuals.
Private individuals. The interaction between the buyers and the sellers. Okay. The business firms or the private individuals. Okay, with the interaction with the consumers, they will fix the price. That's the importance of market economy. Market economy, right? So where we can find the market economy? What kind of economic system it is? Capital economy or capital economy or?
What do you mean by
capital economy? Where all the means of production is controlled by the
individuals.
Private individuals, correct. Okay. We can find this market economic system in a capitalist economy and a mixed economy. Okay, capitalist economy and a mixed economy. Almost all the socialist economies example for command economy, where the government will fix the price. Government will fix the price. Yes or no? Is that correct or not? We discussed that, right or not?
Yes.
I am giving statements here. You are accepting that or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, of course. Fine. So we are moving to the next one. So next topic, we already discussed that. What is the difference between normative economics and positive economics? Normative and positive. One is subjective, the other is objective. Which, what is subjective? What is subjective?
Normative economics.
Okay, normative economics is subjective. Okay. So normativity is subjective. At the same time, positive economy is objective. Positive economy is always dealing with the present scenario in an economy. Present scenario in an economy. That's basically related with the present demand, supply, and the price. And the price. It can give predictions related with the present situations. Okay, positive economics. But normative economics is subjective. It is always prescribing what we want to do in an economy. What we want to do in an economy for the welfare of the people or for the welfare of the entire country. Okay. So positive economics is free from subjective analysis, and normative economics is always related with the personal or value judgment. So positive economics is always have an approach of a scientist. The same time, normative economics always have an approach of a politician. That much we discussed. Okay. Next one, we know that we already know not what do you mean by microeconomics and what is a macroeconomics. Okay, so Indian economy is an example of Indian economy. Is that a capitalist, is that socialist, or a mixed?
Mixed.
Indian economy is an example of a mixed economy, right? Okay, fine. So these are the basic things. Now this is your turn. You can ask me. If you want explanation for any particular topic, you can ask me. No problem. We will discuss that one more time. All together we will discuss. Ask me. Adul, anything?
No, sir.
Nothing. Okay, Hanna Salim? Nothing. So, now I am going to give some idea related with the next chapter in statistics textbook, right? So, we discussed about how to collect data. How to collect data. Learned or not, how to collect data? What are the different methods? Right. Now we are going to discussing about how to present the collected data. How to present the collected data. Okay. Okay. Just understand the things there. Just background. Okay. We are discussing how can we reach that chapter. What are the basic things in that chapter there. So we might find news reports. Okay. So Amal Raj.
Yes, sir.
Now I will say one incident. You want to make a report, a newspaper reporter regarding with that particular incident. Okay. A plane crashed. 24 passengers, 20 dead, 4 survivors. Place, Ludhiana. Tell me, make a report. Wrote or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So what is that? What I told? A plane crashed.
A plane has crashed.
Wait. Crashed.
In Libya.
Wait. 24 passengers.
20 dead.
4 survivors. One more it is. Okay. 16 males, 4 females. Ludhiana. Okay, now make a report and tell me. Make it fast. Come on, Amalraj, fast.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
A plane crash occurred in Ludhiana. 20 people dead. Heading. Now down the...
Heading. 20 people. Plane crash at Ludhiana. Death 20. Death toll 20. Okay, fine. Good. Then...
So then the place name will be the first then static. A plane crash occurred in Libya which killed 20 people and four survivors.
Four survived.
There are total 16 males and 4 females.
Okay, so the thing is clear for it's called to be textual representation, right or not? We got some datas. What is that? One plane, 24 passengers, 20 died, 16 males, 4 females, 4 survivors, right or not? And the place is Ludhiana. So this kind of representation is basically called as textual representation, right or not? Textual representation. So basically, newspaper reports are related with the textual representation of data. Textual representation of data. All the newspaper reports are like that only, right or not? So some newspaper, we can see that example in our state, Malayalam Manorama, right? That's a daily. Okay, if an incident occur, what kind of report they will give? Textual report will be there. A graphical representation will be there. Right or not? Like that, various things we can find in their news report. Their news report. Is that correct? Is that clear for you? Now understood what you mean by textual data presentation? Just a report. Next one is called what? Tabular data presentation. Tabular. Tables. Okay. You are observed the tables. Okay, in your textbook you can see that, right? Okay, I will say that page number. Just observe that. You can see what is a tabular representation. Tabular representation. A table. Take page number 44. Take that. Textbook of statistics for economics. You can use statistics textbook, page number 44. Observe that. Observed or not? Yes, that's going to be a tabular representation of data there. Okay, so in the before page, page number 43, you can see number of tables. Number of data is clearly represented. By seeing the table, we are easily understanding. We are able to understand that. When that incident, what are the people they engaged in that? What is the result? Okay, units are there, measurements are there. Like number of data are perfectly mentioned, right or not? Very easily, or we are able to understand easily those things there, what happened. Okay, comparing with the textual representation, it is somewhat easy to understand the situation here through a tabular representation, right or not? Yes or no? Give me some comment. Is it yes or no? Is that correct or not? Are you able to understand the things easier in a tabular representation?
Yes,
of course. Okay. So these are the things basically we are dealing in the next chapter there. Next one is a graphical representation of data. Graphical representation. Number of different types of graphs are there. Okay. Histogram, bar graphs are there. Okay. Pie diagram. Ajay. Okay, like the number of methods are there. That are the basic thing we are going to discuss in the next chapter there. So homework for you for the next class. You want to prepare for the examination. That's a major and important thing. You want to prepare well for the examination. I told you what is the pattern for the question paper. Pattern of the question paper we discussed. How many chapters are there? We discussed that. So prepare well for the examination. Okay, so presentation of data. Chapter number 4, page number 40. So page number 40, 41, 42, and 43. Okay, up to page number 43, subheading 4. Up to that you should read and understand the things. We will discuss that in the next class. Okay, so I am going to wind up.